What is going on? All right, so today we're going to be talking about something that a lot of people bring up. So there's three things that's going to be happening, obviously. So welcome to BPIU. BPIU, we're actually going to be going to a dedicated channel, and this will be the last BPIU video. We're actually going to have a completely different area for any agent videos, because it doesn't really jive with what we want to do and what we want to create and going forward and things like that. We want to do hot topics, market updates. We want to do sellers and buyers and 1031s and all the areas that educate you guys. So really, this is not only the last one, but if you do have any questions as an agent, do leave in the comments below. Shoot me an email, charles@botenston.com. This is a question that I get a lot, all right? So you're either a new agent or you're an agent that's saying, okay, what do I do? I'm kind of in this flux area. You know, I've either stagnated in my business, or I want more, or I want to build a team or something like that. What's the future? So first of all, Gary Keller, I almost said Gary Vaynerchuk, Gary Keller said by year over year in the next, starting in the next 5 years, real estate agents are going to be leaving the industry because of things, unforeseen circumstances. It could be an app, it could be a website, it could be a new technology, as well as that people are just going to, you're going to have the rainmaker, and then you're going to have people below it. In other words, the person that is able to replicate the exact same experience across, it doesn't matter the city or the area, prospecting wise or education wise when it comes to onboarding new agents. So let's talk about, first of all, the big box brokerages in New York City. That's Corcoran, Elliman, Halstead, Brown, Howard, Stevens, Sotheby's, you know, Compass, things like that. Then you have the smaller shops, which, you know, obviously that's probably up to about 150, 200 people. And then you also, nationally, you obviously have Keller Williams, Remax, Coldwell Banker, things like that. And one of the big, what's the other one? Berkshire Hathaway. So what's the difference between those big box shops, the smaller ones, and then I'm going to be talking about teams next, all right? So the big box shops, why were they successful? They were successful back in the day because they not only had all of the money, because they formed and they didn't collude, but they formed and they said, okay, I have all the money, I have all the agents, this is what we're gonna offer the agents, and this is what we're gonna offer the people. We're gonna have awareness, we're gonna have offices, we're gonna have offices on the first floor, in other words, ground level, you can see us, we're gonna be all over the place, we're gonna be able to advertise in the New York Times, we're gonna advertise nationally, we're gonna have brand deals, we're gonna be able to sponsor at the New York Yankees like Halstead does. In other words, they have so much money, they're able to go on a big breath and depth on advertising and marketing. And that's what they also offered the agents, is that we have so much money, we can create not only our own CRMs, but marketing. It's more professional. We're also gonna have managers and beautiful offices and office supplies. We're gonna have assistants. We're gonna have anything you need. You just walk in, you produce, and you give us 50%, and then you keep on producing. Then you started going to a smaller shop, which is, a smaller shop is you're gonna get a little bit more customer. You're not gonna get the big brand names that everyone knows. And, you know, people started leveraging that. But then also on the smaller shop is that if you go to that place, you're gonna be able to actually get an experience as an agent way more in depth. Your marketing or your actual training is gonna just increase exponentially. And then that started taking off because obviously the smaller guys, you're able to work as a team. It's more cohesive. It's probably not going to be ground level. You're also not going to be sponsoring at the New York Yankees. So they were a little bit more frugal on their money, and they actually use metrics to actually ensure that where they're spending their money was working. Then you move on to teams. So I think that teams are going to be the future, and teams that are independently run as a team. So in other words, that's essentially that what I want to grow out, is that teams within teams, all right? They do that out in, I forgot the name of the agent, but he's out, I think, in Iowa, and he has teams within teams. He's owned by Berkshire Hathaway, and he's considered a team within Berkshire Hathaway, and then they have teams within the team within Berkshire Hathaway. It gets a little complicated, obviously, with the commission structure. But essentially, what you're looking at is just an array of people that are able to give the same experience. What do I mean by that? Someone comes in, they say, I'm looking to buy. They have a checklist for new buyers. They meet with the person, they give them the buyer's report, they set them on alerts, and they just go down this checklist of things. If it's a seller, we're gonna order all the marketing, we're gonna be able to sponsor here, we're gonna then have our first open house, we're gonna do our mailing, we're gonna do our video and things like that. And we just give the same exact experience. It was the same thing. I just talked with an owner. And they said, you know, what's going on over there? Are we having a lot of people showing up? Are we having a lot of web traffic? And essentially, I'm saying we're giving what we gave to your neighbor the exact same experience that we're giving you, because they actually contacted us because of how high we sold their neighbor's home. Obviously, it's a different marketplace, but they want the exact same experience. I said, you're receiving the exact same experience. It's just a different marketplace. And I go over exactly what they got. All right. So why is the team model going to be so successful? Because at the high level, you don't need to be sponsoring on New York Times. You don't need to be sponsoring on for the Yankees to be the preferred partner of the New York Yankees. All right. You don't need to be going to, say, a grocery store and being on all the shopping carts, or being on the MTA subway. Like, that's not enough. If you actually create a really good marketing campaign, if you give really good customer service and you get not only customer feedback and reviews, and you publish them, and obviously you spread that out, spread the word, is you're gonna be able to leverage that for other clients online. Online. That's the most important thing, is that that's why I started BPI, is that I said, I don't actually need this big box shop of Halstead, and I don't need a smaller one of people telling me this is the best way to do it, you should do this way, you should do that way. I said, I want a team organization. Obviously, in the beginning, it's kind of like, here's how to fish, but then I'm also going to be, I'm going to actually say, here is fish, but then I'm going to teach them how to fish. And that's our onboarding experience. So in conclusion, big box shop, honestly, I think there's going to be a big disruption. I think a lot of them are sitting on a massive overhead that they're not going to be able to support. The smaller guys are going to be able to decrease and be a little bit more flexible on their cost and their savings and things like that. On the smaller guys, this is where I highly recommend anyone that's actually successful, is that you move to that kind of organization where you move your you move to a team model. And if you're an individual agent, you have to build out your team, because that's the only way to actually, I feel, to be not only successful, but to be able to replicate the exact same experience. You know, the E-Myth is an incredible book, and it talks about the reason that McDonald's has the exact same McDonald's in New York as it does in California, or the exact same Hilton as it does in New York, in Miami, is because they have the exact same processes. When a guest checks in, this is what happens. When they have a complaint, this is what happens. When they leave the room, this is how you clean the room. This is how you set up the room. This is how you fold the towels. This is where you put the soap. Everything is just, it's just systematized. And it just makes it a little bit easier. And here's the kicker, is that you get the exact same experience everywhere. And that's exactly what customers are looking for, the exact same experience, whether they go with you in this year or they go with you next year. In other words, they use you this year to buy or sell, or they use you, or their friend uses you, they want the exact same experience. Not, well, this person was treated better than that person. No. You have the exact same experience. So I feel the future is going to be teams, or it's going to be smaller organizations that are able to customize the experience to, say, the Upper West Side, or lofts, or co-ops, or families that are, you know, or people, I should say, that are moving to New York City, things like that. So if you guys have any questions, leave in the comments below. This is going to be our last BPIU. As mentioned, we're going to be going over to a dedicated platform, so we're going to be shooting those videos. All that information is going to be coming out. If you guys have any questions, leave in the comments below. And of course, if you want to reach me personally, Charles@BPI Live. We're going to be really coming out with a lot of really good content. So if you guys have any questions, definitely get involved. All right. Have an amazing Friday.